In Salinas, continuing coverage on the mounting pressure surrounding Alisal School District trustee and Salinas City Councilman Jose Castaneda. Today, the City Council initiated an action aimed at determining what, if anything, should be done to resolve their concerns over the fact that Castaneda is holding two offices at the same time. Action News reporter Felix Cortez has the exclusive details.
Standing room only at the Salinas Council Chambers as people weigh in on the Castaneda controversy.
Sure, you were voted into office, but you should have resigned on this Alisal Union School Board. You know it, I know it, we know it. Wake up, people.
He won the election. You know, you can't kick a person out or penalize someone for winning an election. You have too many issues to deal with as a city.
Jose Castaneda's decision to hold on to his Alisal School Board seat after being elected to the City Council continues to draw the wrath of some, but the support of others. On Tuesday, at least two City Council members said the dilemma is a distraction, and Castaneda's colleagues have more questions than answers.
This is one legal issue we need to address and we can no longer avoid. The City Council needs to address this single issue, the legal risk, and get it resolved, the sooner the better.
I really enjoy working with you, and I don't really have any interest in removing you from office. I want you to be here, and I know you're here, but I need somebody from a higher office to say it's cool that you have both seats.
Tuesday, finally action taken that could help answer that. It came from Councilwoman Jill Lutz, who requested the council hold a closed-door session to consider the issue. She also wants a letter sent to the Alisal School District seeking answers from them. She wants an independent legal opinion, and she left open the possibility of bringing in the Attorney General's office. A defiant Castaneda said all that would be a waste of time and money.
But one question that I will ask, either I'm right and everyone else is wrong, or everyone else is right and I'm wrong. So think about that. And what's the bigger question of all this is, what does this accomplish at the end? It does not accomplish anything else other than about $30,000 to $35,000 down the drain.
Indications are Castaneda will hold on to both seats until told otherwise. And Tuesday, he lashed out against his critics, including the Californian newspaper and the president and general manager of KSBW, Joe Heston.
There's a personal thing going on between myself and Mr. Heston. He will still not debate me in public. He can bring all his attorneys, and I'll bring myself. Simple as that.
Castaneda may want to bring his attorneys to the next city council meeting on March 19th, when the council is expected to get an update regarding his standing. At City Hall in Salinas, Felix Cortez, KSBW, Action News 8.